Welcome to the subcommittee of the Health and Human Services Committee. We have one bill on our agenda today, House Bill 520. It's for a hearing only. We're not voting on this bill today. Let me just remind you, we're going to limit individuals to 2 minutes just because we've got a long list of people signed up and we may not get to everybody today. And we'll get started. Next is Brant Meadows.
Thank you, Senators, for ridding Georgia of TikTok and Chinese tracking. Yes. Mental Health Equity 1.0 HB 1013 was gutted by senators a year ago. Senators prudently removed numerous references to the World Health Organization's definition for mental health and stopped the possibility of TikTok-like Chinese biometric wristbands and components from being used in Georgia mental health care. Now Mental Health Equity 2.0 HB 520 unexplainably allows for TikTok-like tracking, but 10 times worse. Mental Health Parity 2.0 fails to provide any meaningful definitions, as you've heard here. What is mental health? What is mental illness? What is serious mental illness? What is monitoring? HB 520 cites these things numerous times. Who monitors? How do you monitor? Are these going to use Chinese components, pieces, and parts for monitoring? Who maintains the data? What if the company that's there sells their company? Then what happens to the data? Presumably, these questions will be left up to a few elite mental health czars. And if I'm wrong, then what would be the harm in banning any and all aspects related to China as it results to any and all monitoring of any kind relative to Mental Health Equity 2.0? There would be no harm, so why not do that? But the most important information is during last year's Senate hearings for HB 1013 was that Mental Health Equity was overturned on March 22, 2022 by the Federal Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals, Witt versus United Behavioral Health. Had that been known by this body a year ago, Georgia Mental Health Equity would not have just been gutted, but it would have been halted. The very name of last year's bill, HB 1013, Mental Health Equity, was based on the notion that a federal mandate existed for mental health equity. There are ample arguments during last year's hearing based on a federal mandate which no longer exists. That was deliberately withheld from this body. I have supplied, and I believe somebody's going to pass out the open records that I obtained, to where the proponents and one of the bill sponsors deliberately withheld that information during the Senate hearings last year. That is wrong. That should not have stopped. That should have stopped. Please oppose HB 520. Table it. Don't let this legislation go any further. Thank you.
Next, Roland Behm.
Madam Chair, members of the committee, I'm grateful for the opportunity to speak to you today. I come in here in strong support of HB 520. As you mentioned, my name is Roland Behm. I volunteer and serve as a board member with the Georgia chapter of the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention. To clear up a misunderstanding, it is not a psychopharma organization. It's a volunteer organization that happens to provide the largest amount of private funding for suicide prevention research in the United States. So let's deal with the facts and move from there. I'm also the co-founder of the Georgia Mental Health Policy Partnership today. My remarks focus on three things. One, the studies and task forces under HB 520 are not an expansion of state government. Georgia is at the beginning of a journey to transform mental health and substance use care in the state. The studies and task forces will create the map for that journey. Absent a map, Georgia's journey will be aimless and costly, both in terms of individual health outcomes and taxpayer funds. The studies and task forces will provide transparency and accountability for the journey, and there is a need to ensure that behavioral health care in the state achieves the best results while ensuring that government is an effective steward of taxpayer funding. Second, data referenced in HB 520 are safeguarded by state and federal laws and regulations. Those safeguards are a function of the data itself and exist independent of the bill. Unless required to ensure the health and safety of an individual, no data can be used to personally identify Georgia citizens. The DIF identified data currently exists and is being used by individual agencies. The bill enables the sharing of the de-identified data to create the behavioral health care map that we need. Third, HB 520 does not expand Medicaid in Georgia. As you heard from Chairman Jones, nothing in HB 520 results in an increase in the number of Medicaid enrollees, nor does it require any additional funding by Georgia for its Medicaid programs. The bill provides most effective treatment options for Medicaid enrollees. Thank you.
Okay, next, Mallory Staples.
Thank you.